Alright, so peace, ladies and gentlemen. Aki Aminakwaf. This is Quan coming through once again with another video, another little segment. And I just wanted to touch on this video in regards to Oprah Winfrey and you know, her conducting her interview with some couple, I guess. And it's revolved around, you know, child abuse and child molestation. And basically, what her spiel is based off of her trying to make child abuse or child molestation palatable to the masses because of what she says as far as, you know, the abuser being more so loving and caring and it being good for the victim. So it's just crazy how they try to twist this up in regards to the paradigm so they can make it more acceptable for people to view this as something that's, you know, cool. They're trying to make it, you know, a part of the LGBTQ, which is already fucking disgusting in and of itself. So let's just go into this video real quick.
In 2019, Oprah Winfrey had a special with child abuse victims of Michael Jackson. She went on to explain that when done right, child abuse feels good.
So this is what so many people don't understand. A big part of the confusion and shame for child victims is that the attention and the seduction from the predator, who is probably going to be somebody you know.
Right.
In order for it to work, it has to be somebody you know, somebody you admire, somebody you respect, or maybe...
And look at the shirt that she's wearing. Well, under her her little jacket or whatever that is, it's in a form of a pyramid. And that's on purpose. That's purposeful. That's meant to convey a certain message because it's congruent with the subject. Because the pyramid is all based in what? The esoteric Luciferian understanding as far as the eye of providence and, you know, the eye of Heru or the all-seeing eye, so on and so forth. So it has a lot to do with, you know, the esoteric component in regards to where they get these ideologies from as far as that the rights when it comes to child abuse and so on and so forth. Because, you know, the rights as far as the paganism goes back to the god Pan, in which he performed, you know, pedophilia on the kids. So it's always a connection. So she's wearing that because it's a significance in regards to it having to do with the esoteric component. And the color of it is purple. And we know what purple represents. So it's very, 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 like, telling in regards to what they really want to tell you subconsciously. You feel what I'm saying?
Be even love. And it feels good. I mean, if you're 7 years old and somebody, which I was trying to say this to my friends who had children, you're 7 years old and someone is stroking your penis, it feels good. Even though you don't have a name for what that is, it feels good.
It's like, why are you trying to go to great lengths to emphasize that it feels good at 7 years old? A 7 year old shouldn't even be thinking about what that feels like. You know what I mean? It's crazy. Like, these people will really show themselves. Now, I don't know if this is like represented on a mass scale in regards to this video. I don't know if a lot of people seen this video, but something tells me that this is something that they didn't want people to see. And it's just telling, you know what I mean? Because weeks ago, people were saying that Oprah Winfrey was tweeting about having a child sex slave ring. And she was saying that she was hacked. But the proof is always in the pudding, man. You know, what they withhold from the masses in regards to the public, it's a reason why they conceal these things. It's a reason why they withhold it. Because if you find out, or if you come across any sort of truth that has something to do with it, you know, you're deemed, you become incredulous, but you're deemed somebody that's a conspiracy theorist because you're privy to something that not everybody's privy to. Therefore, you're deemed a conspiracy theorist or you're crazy or what have you. You know what I mean? It's always the remnant of people that understand as opposed to the majority of people that don't understand but think they do. You feel what I'm saying? And that's the world we live in. It's confusion.
First said this years ago, people were like, you're crazy because everybody wants to believe it's like sexual assault and you're being thrown up against the wall and you're being raped. And I have said for years, if the abuser is any good, you won't even know it's happened. You will be in it and you won't even know it's happened. And if the abuser is any good, he or she is going to make you feel like you're a part of it. I mean, and nothing is more being a part of it than what we discussed earlier. Then you have, you say you were married. You had marriage vows and you have rings.
Right.
This is ridiculous. And you see how Oprah is really emphasizing the effects of it. She's saying, oh, you say you were married. So she's trying to basically say that, you know, it's a good thing that this had happened to you guys when you were younger, because now the result of that is marriage. But marriage between two men, which is confusion, which is wrong, which obviously is something that's self-defeating. But they promote it because why? They want people to follow this Luciferian energy. They want you to be subjected to this vibration that's based in Satanism. And everything that's contrary to the Most High, the laws, statutes, and commandments. This shit is so weird. This society is so upside down. It's so backwards. Well, we must come back to the true understanding so we can disavow ourselves from any of this nonsense that we see that's pervasive in this society. Because it's strong, man. It's very, very strong. And we have to be steadfast in the faith, because this world is coming to an end and it's crumbling. But let me continue on.
Oprah legitimized the notorious sex criminal Joe Teixeira, aka John of God, as a miraculous faith healer, one who could cure cancer, giving him international recognition. Joe Teixeira is now serving 19 years in prison for the rape of four women. He is facing additional cases related to several sex crimes, including keeping teenage women as sex slaves in underground mines, forcing them to have his children, and selling their babies internationally for tens of thousands of dollars before murdering the women after about 10 years of childbirth. Oprah runs her own leadership academy for girls in Africa, a $40 million school for disadvantaged girls, where in 2007, several children were sexually abused and parents were only allowed to see their children once a month.
2007, it tells you that 700 kids were abused. So it's just letting you know that that's a culture, man. That's a part of that culture in regards to the mainstream, in regards to the upper levels of society, what they perform, what they do. You know, you have a child sex slave ring out there in Haiti that was conducted by Hillary Clinton that was under the rug. You know, you look at the Juan Epstein case and Tom Hanks and all these celebrities, man. These people, they fucking disgusting creatures, man. They sick ass people. And they believe in this because it goes back to the gods that they worship. They worship these gods in which the rites and the rituals was based in pedophilia and child molestation and incest and drug and blood drinking, so on and so forth. They partake in these things because they believe in it. They believe in the pagan ideologies and so on and so forth. So they just recreate what was done in the ancient times in regards to the things that the Most High told us not to do, but other nations were doing, including our nation as far as, like, you know, Israel. But for the most part, the majority of the Israelites were not doing that, but, you know, we all fall as a nation. So the Most High, he gave us consequences based off of that, based off of the mass, you know, majority of Israelites doing that. But we all fall as a nation. But just to not to digress, it just goes to show you that these people, they take great lengths to do these things in regards to it being a culture thing. It's just not, you know, conveyed to the masses that this is something that they do, but they're trying to, like, slowly but surely make it more acceptable so people won't look at it like, oh my God, this is so heinous, this is so wrong, even though in actuality it is. It's just they're trying to make it acceptable and make it as if it's not. And that's the world for you. That's Satan. That's the trickery for you. That's deception. And that's why we have to be able to spot it and discern it so we could become better people in regards to us discerning the spirituality aspect. Because that's all it boils down to, is us having our spiritual acuity, our mental acuity onto a T. Excuse me.